One of the things that was they showed in the video was my first night here. Got here and 4 o'clock in the morning, I just couldn't sleep. So I just went out for a walk. And so I came across that that pirate ship bridge and just kept going. And it was really kind of bizarre and neat, but I just kept walking through town. So I am going to pick up shortly after I found that little park. So this is the first chapter. Continuing on my walk, I find myself in a cobblestoned pedestrian zone. I pass closed cafes and bakeries, high-end clothes stores and boutiques, chocolatiers, jewelers, watch shops, and eyeglass stores. Lots of eyeglass stores. It's pretty. Neat, clean, and tidy. I make a turn, and the buildings become more Europe-y. Ancient sandstone structures with ornate archways and fancy overhanging window awnings. On the corner, there's an old stone church with a steeple that reaches high above the streetlights into the darkness. At some point, I hear the clitter-clatter of high heels upon pave behind me and turn to see three young people staggering my way, two guys and a girl. The young woman is singing in French, and as she approaches more closely, I can see is extremely pretty. She is the second thing in Luxembourg that spurs a knee-jerk, wow. The first thing was the pirate ship. She's got curves galore, shrink-wrapped in black, and dark, wavy tresses that bounce and bob alluringly as she sings in French. In her hand, she holds a glass of champagne. It's like something out of a Fellini movie and a lot for me to take in. Did I mention that she was singing in French? I don't much notice her companions until one of them speaks to me. Bonjour, he says, to which I have no idea how to respond. Wie geht's, says the other. When I still don't respond, the first one says, what's up, in a phony American accent. Hi, I manage. Wow, cool, my first conversation with a Luxemburger. Then, weed, says the first guy. He's short and dark with a dark slicked back pompadour and a finely razored little beard. Excuse me, I respond. Weed, do you know where we can find some weed? Clarifies the second one. Neither one of them, he's a carbon copy of the first guy, except not as short. Neither one of them is as tall as the woman. Curvy chanteuse, my jet-lag brain dubs her. She listens, eyeing me curiously while sipping from her champagne glass. No, sorry, I answer. I just got here a few hours ago. Disappointed, the guys start to leave, but curvy chanteuse stays put. Where do you got here from? She asks me in an adorable French accent that some might find off the charts sexy. America, near Seattle, I answer. My family and I just moved here. This impresses them. Good, I think. Luxembourgers apparently don't hate Americans. But it seems to confuse them also. You moved from Seattle to Luxembourg? Asks the first guy with a look of almost repulsive disbelief. There's nothing to do here, says the other guy. You're going to be very depressed. You're going to need Prozac to live here. Turns out they're not Luxembourgers at all, but rather French folks from just across the border in Thionville. We talk a few minutes more, and then arm in arm with curvy chanteuse in the middle, the three of them resume their pursuit of cannabis down the cobbled walkway ahead of me, singing some drunken song as they go. I watch, not quite sure what to make of our little moment together. They're about to disappear around a corner when curvy chanteuse breaks from her friends and turns back to me. Good luck, Seattle boy, she shouts and waves goodbye. So that was my first night in Luxembourg. Merci. It was quite a welcome, and I always kind of took that as a good omen, this good luck, Seattle boy. You know, it's nice. Now I'd like to read something about language. As I was in the video, I've became very, very obsessed and interested and obsessed with language. Living in Luxembourg, you really can't help but become obsessed. And in fact, this week I'm taking the two Luxembourg language tests. Monday I had the Hirnverstehen. That was so hard. That was so hard. And then Friday I have the Sprechen test. So I have to describe what people are wearing, and I see my friend Paul, is that Paul? Paul is wearing a Kariert him. And Kariert him, is that right?
Yeah.
Karyotium. Him. Okay, you take the test for me, please. Please. Can I pay you? Yeah. So, anyone else wearing something Karyot? I like that word. I think, is that a good. We're all wearing career?
Yes.
Yeah, so I thought I saw a geblumelt something. Geblumelish shawl? Okay. All right, I'm a work in progress. Okay, so here is something about language and Luxembourg's many languages. Certainly, one of the big concerns for an American moving to Europe is the language issue. Especially if, like me and most Americans, you're a hopeless monoglot whose multilingual skills can best be summed up as null, nada, zilch, less than or equal to zero, not even a smidge, and too tiny to be seen with the naked eye. Will I be able to communicate with anyone is a common concern. Will I be forced to learn another language? Franz, will every American movie and TV show be dubbed in some weird foreign language speak? At restaurants, will I forever be looking down in horror at a plate of frog's legs or deer eyeballs or the hindquarters of a wild boar because I once again screwed up trying to order? Thus, the typical American is faced with a multitude of choices on how best to navigate the Luxembourg linguistic landscape. He or she can, one, continue to speak only English, but do so loudly and while adding wild hand gesticulations and exaggerated facial expressions for emphasis. Not that this is particularly useful to Luxembourgers, as the most multilingual folks in Europe, they speak English as well as anyone, but go ahead and do it anyway. It gives them a good laugh. Number two, you can learn French. Seemingly everyone in Luxembourg City shops, restaurants, and offices speaks French, and often only French. But what about those English adept Luxembourgers, you ask? Well, here's the thing. They make up only 55% of Luxembourg's population, and only a third of Luxembourg City's residents are Luxembourgish. Thus, one could reason that the best option for an American, that is, moi, is to learn French. However, and this is a double XL size however, given that my complete French vocabulary before I moved to Luxembourg consisted of the following: French fries, French toast, and French kiss, learning French is a big ask. Now, I won't bore you with my attempts to learn French or the unimportant details of my struggles to learn and speak it. Like the time I tried to use French to ask at a grocery store, checker for a plastic bag. En sachet, I intended to ask. But instead, I said, enchanté, which means nice to meet you. To which the confused checker smiled but didn't offer a bag. So I repeated this request, but louder and while pointing at the bags. Enchanté, enchanté, enchanté. It was only later that I realized I'd been pointing at a stack of plastic bags and saying, nice to meet you, nice to meet you, nice to meet you. Okay, but I won't bore you with that. Anyway, so option number three is to learn German. Because I studied German for two years decades ago when I was a surly teen, I figured that I had a leg up, as it were, on lingual integration into my new country. Nice thought. In reality, I lived in Luxembourg City for more than a year before hearing a single word of spoken German. And that was only when some Deutschland tourist stopped me in Place d'Armes and asked, Entschuldigung, wo ist die Pizza Hut? Before I moved here, okay, number four, learn Luxembourgish. Before I moved here, I Googled the heck out of Luxembourg and came away with the impression that Luxembourgish was an obscure, rarely spoken dialect. Yes, as I said in the video, I remember going to a going away party before I moved and someone asked me what language they speak in Luxembourg. French and German, I answered. There is something called Luxembourgish, but nobody speaks it anymore except for old people. Not true. And with the increasing number of foreigners moving to Luxembourg, more and more people are learning Luxembourgish all the time, including me. I signed up for a Luxembourgish class after I'd been living here for about a year. And one of the first things I learned was that the Luxembourgish phrase for this is, akin to the French say, is dat ass. This impressed me. and convince me that I had chosen to pursue the right language. French might be the language of love, but only Luxembourgish is the language of dat ass. Thank you, thank you. Anybody have any questions or anything? Or has the traffic gotten better? Or? No? You can't hear me? Okay, let me see. I also teach English. So I teach English to, obviously, not Luxembourgers. I've never taught English to a Luxembourger because they already know how to speak it. And so I teach at various businesses around the city, and I'm teaching people from all over the world, Morocco, Togo, China, along with Belgium, France, and, you know, Germany. And they're not newcomers. They're people who know how to speak it, but they want to get better, and they want to be just able to lead meetings and stuff. So I'm never like, this is a pencil or anything. So right off the bat, we're always having pretty funny conversations because they just want to talk. And so I wanted to read something about a particular student I had who I guess she's probably my favorite that I've had over the years. Her name is Selma, not her real name, and she is a Moroccan woman. Okay, so over the next few weeks, this Moroccan woman, whom I'll call Selma, turned out to be one of my all-time favorite students. Largely because she was so unlike anyone I'd ever met in my admittedly whitey McWhite bread American life. She had thick black hair and dark eyes, and as a Muslim, she told us that 5 times a day she took out her prayer rug and said her prayers. Every day, no matter what, she told me. She was a fascinating study in contrast, for along with being a Moroccan Muslim who grew up in France, she went to a Catholic boarding school where she attended early morning mass daily. One day before class started, Selma and I were making small talk, and she told me she works at an office in Strassen. As she described where it was, I realized I was quite familiar with the area because I often rode my bike through there on my way to a friend's house. As we talked, we pinpointed the location using nearby landmarks, the Pizza Hut, a medical supply store, a hair salon, etc. "It's near the Madonna," she said. I knew exactly which one she was talking about. Luxembourg is a Catholic country, and there are many statues of Jesus and Mary and Jesus in public places. In Strassen, there's one I always pass at this corner that I was pretty sure was near her office. "Madonna is one minute away from the office," she said, holding up her finger for emphasis. Wow, I thought, this woman is so interesting. Along with doing her Muslim prayers 5 times a day, she apparently is doing something else at this Madonna as well. I mean, why else would she know that it's just 1 minute away? Perhaps, I imagine, when her coworkers go outside for smoke breaks, she instead runs over to the Madonna to say Catholic prayers, perhaps even the rosary. I didn't know. "And what do you do at this Madonna?" I asked. I didn't want to pry, but still, I was curious. "Do you go there to pray?" "At McDonald's?" she asked, confused. "Why would I pray at McDonald's? I go there for lunch." Ah, yet another incident of a French speaker pronouncing McDonald's in a way that sounds nothing, I mean absolutely nothing at all, like McDonald's. In this case, Selma pronounced it Madonna, and the closest thing I can approximate it to was Madonna. I once had a different group of French students who were excitedly talking about going to Magic Land. "Magic Land," I asked, "what's that? A theme park like Wally Gator World or Disneyland, what?" "No, no, no, Magic Land," they said, shaking their heads, "where you have the Big Mac and the French fries." Selma once told me that during the first Gulf War in the 1990s, she and her schoolmates had to go to morning mass extra early each day so that they could pray for the coalition forces in the fight against Iraq, a Muslim country. I asked her if that was weird. "What is weird?" she asked. "Strange, unusual, bizarre," I answered. "Of course it was weird," she said. "I asked my father, I said, Papa, why do we have to get up early to do Catholic prayers? And he said, there is only one God. It doesn't matter how you pray to him. What matters is what you pray for. So just pray for peace." Okay. That was Selma. I thought that was a cool story. How's everybody doing out here? Your legs getting tired from standing? Yeah? would you like to hear another one? Yes? Okay. Cool. Tip top. This one, I will dedicate this one to my friend Gianmarco. Okay. A Luxembourg friend once sent me a photo of a street sign in Graveldange that read, "Kechusser." It was accompanied by the following message: "Hey Mike, I'm not sure what that name means, so I'd like to get the opinion of a Luxembourgish language expert, as you are. Can you help me?" Oh, that's curious, I thought to myself. A lifelong Luxembourger is asking me, an American who's fluent in English and only English, to translate a Luxembourgish word for him, praising me as a Luxembourgish language expert to boot. Call me crazy, but I suspected that my friend was pulling my leg. A quick visit to the excellent Luxemburger online dictionary confirmed my suspicions. K is the plural of co, which means cow. And Schusser translates to, well, what do you know? Diarrhea. Thus, the English translation of the street named Kechusser is cow's diarrhea. Not just one cow, but multiple, apparently. On my many and varied bike rides throughout Luxembourg, I've found that most roads and streets here are named in a straightforward, utilitarian, and helpful fashion. If you're riding a road called Route de Gilsdorf, you can bet that it leads to Gilsdorf. Just like a street called Rue de l'École or Rue des Châteaux will take you to a school or a castle, etc. Thus, one must suppose that a street called Kechusser will deliver you to a pasture stocked with dozens of digestively distressed cattle. Hell of a thought, that. Thing is, this isn't the only road in Luxembourg with a name having to do with cows and their intestinal issues, let's say. Down in Pétange, there's a street called Rue de l'Hôtel de Ville. But on the sign, just below the French name, is written its Luxembourgish name, Mache de Poules V, which translates to Liquid Manure Alley. Continuing this theme, if I may, in one of my Luxembourgish classes, we students learned the word piffcall, which in English translates to a cesspit for liquid manure. Yes. I can't help but wonder if the above street names are holdovers from a bygone era when naughty eight-year-olds were put in charge of coming up with Luxembourg place names. I mean, how else did the following Luxembourg villages get their names? Dickweiler, Assel, Pissange, and Arsdorf. I digress. My whole point in this is to say that with Luxembourg's rich agricultural history, it perhaps makes sense that Luxembourg has so many words for cow dung and the like. It's similar to the way that the Inuits are said to have 50 different words for snow. Something else I find interesting about Luxembourgish is that despite its creativity when it comes to naming cow pies, it doesn't have a word for to love. French has aimer, as in je t'aime. German has lieben, as in ich liebe dich. But Luxembourgish, for all its Machtepuls and pithcalls and Kechussers, is loveless. No, it's the form to love that Luxembourgish lacks. The Luxembourgish noun for love is leeft. Thankfully, the language does offer a way to share one's love sentiments. Instead of a single word, it has a construction, gär hun. To say I love you in Luxembourgish, one says ich hun dich gär, which translates literally to I have you gladly. Tying it all together, I can honestly declare that ich hun de viel Luxembourgish Wörter für mischt gär. I love Luxembourg's many words for manure. I do. Okay, I think I will read one last short one. I wanted Franz to read it, but Franz, do you want to read this? Okay. I'm going to need it. No. Oh, yeah, let's see if you can translate it. Okay, so one afternoon, And Franz, by the way, is the guy who's shown in the video. He's right over there. Good buddy of mine. One afternoon, after I'd been living in Luxembourg for a little more than a year, I wrote a song about trying to learn Luxembourgish. Rather, I put my words to the guitar chords of R.E.M.'s It's the End of the World as We Know It. In my hands, it became Dat ist der Luxemburgische Spruch as I know it. But I think, in there I'm singing it Luxembourgish Spruch. 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 Oh, that guy. Okay, as the Luxembourgish Spruch as I know it. I quickly recorded a version with my phone, messaged it to Franz, and he flipped out, calling me immediately. Tomorrow we shoot a video and record the song with my good camera, he said. People will love it. He was spot on. And the YouTube video was shot in and around Abbey Neumünster. Was the first time I had anything that came close to going viral. Given Luxembourg's small size, viral is a relative term. But it was by far the most popular thing I'd done up to that point. The video is basically shots of two guys goofing around the Grund, intercut with me singing and playing the song, not very well at all. But the spirit of fun is genuine, and the scenics are beautiful, and I think that's what people liked. I think, too, that Luxembourgers like the idea that this American was shining a light on and trying to learn their language, something that isn't all that easy to do. So I was going to sing the song now, if you are interested in it. And the words are right here. We can do a sing-along. It's on page 172, if you have to. Okay. Facebook Live. Where's Facebook Live? Are you ready to rock, Facebook Live? Are you ready to rock? Okay. Moin, es in the mic, es wohnen high on the stud. Es lehre Luxembourgisch, but holy shit, it ain't easy. Words like Schlitzschong laughing and Kvetschke besser schmier. Don't forget Sveish, it's got 5 E's in a row. Pompeian has 3 and so does Bommelier. What up with that? Schubert for super gem, Spruder, Wasser, Pieper, Fox, I'm mucka fucka fun to say. Dat ist der Luxemburgische Spruch, as I know. Dat ist der Luxemburgische Spruch, as I know it. Dat ist der Luxemburgische Spruch, as I know it. And is she fine? Novin, good to metis, gargish it, mustard pool, tip top, guns good, footy float, drek sack, velophore, and Shane and dog, vinish cliff, under eye, Franz Schneider, Hema ride, what a guy! Stefontaine's is really simmer, big and village bung a roof, dat ist der Luxemburgische Spruch, as I know. Dat ist der Luxemburgische Spruch, as I know. Dat ist der Luxemburgische Spruch, as I know. Is he fine? Wait a minute, how did we get there? Oh, sorry. Luxembourg's broke, as I know. Dat ist der Luxemburgische Spruch, as I know. Last one. Dat ist der Luxemburgische Spruch, as I know it. And is she fine? Is she fine? Merci, that was great. You guys rock.